This conference will now be recorded.
Hello guys, welcome back. So in this session, once again, GL setting itself, we'll see some more things. Now in a GL setting, what we have done, guys, so we have done the configuration part and even we have created some GL accounts. So now we'll see the field controls. Field controls, like how the fields are getting controlled, because theoretically I have explained like it's account group which is responsible to control the fields which appears during creation of GL account, right? So we'll go to FX00 transaction code, and with the help of this one, we have created our GL account. So look at here, I have set up two GL account. Now look at here, if you have to control the field, say for example, if the client says click here on control data, and let's suppose if the client says that this inflation key or this tolerance group or any other fields are not required, okay, it is not required right now. If you click on edit button, look at here, so in every field certain inputs can be given. If the client says that no, these fields are not required, in that case what is happening, guys? How the fields are getting controlled? So it's pretty simple, guys. As I told you, it is going to be controlled by account group. Okay, so first of all, what you have to do, create one more screen here and then I'll show you. So first of all, you have to check this GL account is created against which account group. So now look at here, this GL account got created under asset account group. Now, so you need to go to where OBD for transaction code, if you guys are able to remember OBD for transaction code, and here check your account group. Your account group, in the sense like your chart of account, is the COA, and against that we have created multiple account groups. So I need to double click on asset account group, and here double click on account control. One by one you have to search this field where it is coming, whether it is a part of account, whether it is appearing under account control or account management or document entry. So you double click on first one, here itself you'll be getting this. Look at here, inflation key tolerance group is there, right? So if the client says I don't need this field, in that case what is happening, guys? You can make it suppress any field. I'm just quoting an example for this inflation key and tolerance group. You can, it is applicable to all fields whichever is appearing here, right? So if I suppress it and save it, just look at here the impact, guys. The impact is here. It means at account group level I have done the changes. And where is the impact? The impact is there at GL account, right? Because the GL accounts are getting created against account group itself. Now I'll just do one thing, guys, to refresh this screen, /NFS00, then the changes whichever we have made is going to be applicable. Now if you are going to have a look here, double click on this bank account and click on control data tab, look at here. Now this this inflation key and both tolerance group is gone. It is not appearing. Apart from this, certain other controls are also there, guys. This is like it is suppressed. Okay, it means totally disappeared. If you want to make it required entry, you can apply a check mark here. In the sense, you can select this radio button, not check mark. There is a difference between radio button and check mark, guys, right? Check mark means, let's suppose if you're having 5 check boxes at a time, you can apply a check mark on 2, 3, 4, 5, all check boxes can be also. But in radio button means only one option can be selected, right? This is what the difference. Now, so here what we have done. Okay, so now once again, you just do /NFS00, and now let me show you. So now what is happening, guys? These fields are converted into required entry field. It means if you click on edit button, look at here, all the fields are normal, whereas this inflation key and tolerance group, this is converted into required entry, because this sign mark kind of symbol is coming. So these fields are required entry. If you don't do anything, if you try to save it, look at here, system is going to throw you error. Why? Because now these fields are required entry, you must have to give certain inputs, right? I'm not going to give any input, guys. Simply I'm going to make changes here. And once again, if you have to, like, okay, optional we have already seen, right? Display means what is happening, those fields are going to appear, but user will not be able to give any input over there. I think some noise is coming anyway. So now what is happening here, this field will appear here, but user will not be able to give any input. /NFS00, this is what the use of display. once again, just go to this bank account. Okay, and here is this tolerance inflation key is there and tolerance group. You just click on edit button. So all fields are editable, whereas these two fields are non-editable. These two fields are non-editable. And if you check this expense account group, double click on here rent account. Look at here, for this one it is editable. Why? Because against rent account group, I have not made any changes, right? So account group wise, it means now under asset account group, let's suppose there is one drawback also, that also I'll explain. Under asset account group, let's suppose I have created HDFC bank. Likewise, even other GL accounts are also there. Let's suppose 100 GL accounts are there, 200 GL accounts are there, or 50 GL accounts are there under a particular account group. So whatever changes are applicable, whatever things we are going to do here at account group level, it means if I have made this suppress, or else optional, or this required, whatever these settings are there, guys, right? Let me save it. So now it is going to be applicable, that is applicable to all GL accounts which is created against this account group. This is what the things, guys. Okay, but apart from this setting is not applicable to other account group, because under expense different settings are there. Hope you guys are able to understand. This is what, like, very clear picture. Very clearly I am explaining all these things, and practically I am showing that how the fields are getting controlled, so that you guys will never forget. Because if you are going for an interview and all, and somebody asks like what kind of control is going to be made by this account groups and all, so it controls the number range. Here number range we have given, that already I have seen, we have seen like during creation of GL account, guys. So it controls the number range, and second thing is it controls the fields also. Which fields? The fields which appears in GL master, in the sense under GL account, whatever the fields are appearing, those fields are getting controlled by this account group. How it is getting controlled? Just now I have shown it. It means at account group level, whatever changes we are going to make, these changes, these results or like those impact is going to be visible here at GL account level. And this is how the fields are getting controlled. So under GL accounts, if any fields supposed to be controlled, guys, if your client is saying that no, I don't want this field, or this field supposed to be a required entry, or any particular field supposed to be, you just made it in a like display mode, then what will happen, guys? This is going to be opted, this can be achieved with the help of account group. You have to make changes at account group level. But there is one more thing. If you are going to apply changes at account group level, then this is applicable to all GL account which is created under a particular account group. That is why what is happening, guys, at the time of creation of account group, we have to explain these things to the client, that these are this is the functionality of account group. It is going to control the fields. At the same time, if we are going to apply any changes at account group level, then it is the changes will be applicable to all GL accounts whichever have been created under a particular account group. Okay, so in that case, what will happen, guys? Once the client is able to understand the functionality, then they will decide that, okay, how many account groups are going to be created. That's what I said, like, creation of account group is not our decision, guys. That is decided by client. We just need to explain what is the functionality of this account group, what is the advantage of this account group, or what is the control, what is going to be controlled by this account group. So once you explain these things, client will tell you that, okay, I need 5, 10, 15, 12, whatever it is, that is going to be decided by those people. So this is how the fields are getting controlled, guys, by account group. So that's all in this session, guys. Now in next session, we'll see the transaction posting.